हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू एजुकेशन इन हैंड्स। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ए टॉपिक कॉल्ड थिन सिलेंडर्स फ्रॉम स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटेरियल्स टू। सो फर्स्ट इफ यू सी व्हाट इज ए थिन सिलेंडर मीन्स, वी आर कंसिडरिंग ए हैलो सिलेंडर लाइक दिस। So if you take the cross section of this cylinder, it is having external diameter as capital D and internal diameter as small d. So the thickness of this cylinder will be equal to T is capital D minus small d. So based on this, how we are defining this thin cylinder means, if the thickness of the cylinder is less than 1/15 to 1/20 of the internal diameter small d, then the cylinder is classified in thin cylinders. Otherwise, it is classified in thick cylinders. That is the another topic. So here our prime concern is thin cylinders. So where we use these thin cylinders in practical applications means, vessels like boilers or compressed air receivers, like the gas cylinders which are available in our homes, we will use these thin cylinders. These are generally used for storing fluids like liquids or gases, and the stress distribution is assumed uniform over the thickness of the wall. So whatever the closed container or the thin cylinder we are considering, the pressure exerted by the fluid is distributed equally on the internal surface. So this is the basic introduction of the thin cylinder. Now let us see this thin cylinder when subjected to internal pressure. Why? Because whatever the fluid we are storing in the thin cylinder is kept under certain pressure. So it is exerting some pressure on the internal walls of the cylinder. Here I am considering a thin cylinder subjected to fluid under pressure P on all the walls of the cylinder. And the cylinder is of internal diameter D and thickness of T, and length L is considered for our calculations. So when we consider this kind of cylinder subjected to internal pressure, there may be a chance of failure in the cylinder. When it will happen, the internal pressure, which is nothing but the P acting on the cylinder, is more than the capacity of the cylinder, then the cylinder may fail. So how it will fail? It may fail in lateral direction or longitudinal direction to the axis. So the first one, it may fail along its length, means it will burst out along the length of the cylinder like this, or it may burst out in the perpendicular direction or longitudinal direction like this. So there are two chances of failing in this cylinder due to the internal pressure. When it will happen means, just when the internal pressure is more than the capacity of the cylinder. So these are the two types of failures. So the first one is circumferential stress or hoop stress. So whenever the liquid pressure exceeds this circumferential stress or hoop stress, then the failure may occur in lateral direction. And the second one is longitudinal stress. So whenever this internal pressure is exceeding this longitudinal stresses, then failure will occur in longitudinal direction. So we will see the first condition where circumferential stresses we will calculate. So here, if we consider a cross section where the failure is happening, it will be like this. Here we are having internal pressure acting on throughout the walls. For that, at the cross section in material, resisting force is applied in the member. That resisting force, which is nothing but the circumferential stress or hoop stress, we will take it as sigma 1. So here the failure of the cylinder, which is nothing but the bursting of the cylinder, will take place if the fluid pressure, which is the internal fluid pressure, is exceeding the resistance due to circumferential stresses. So if P is greater than sigma 1, then this bursting or failure will happen. So in the limiting cases, to limit this bursting failure, the fluid pressure, where the internal fluid is exerting certain pressure, will be equal to the circumferential stresses sigma 1. So if these two are equal, then it is in stabilized condition. But in practical applications, we are not supposed to give the fluid pressure up to sigma 1. We will take care of certain factor of safeties. But here, the limiting condition to not to fail is fluid pressure will be equal to circumferential stresses. So how we calculate this circumferential stresses means, first we will take the fluid pressure P. So this fluid pressure P is acting on surface, that is internal surface, throughout the length. So first force due to fluid pressure, that is P, the pressure value into area on which P is acting. So the area which P is acting is throughout the diameter and throughout the length. So it is D into L. This is the force due to fluid pressure. Then next one is the circumferential stresses. So force due to circumferential stresses is nothing but sigma 1 stress into area of action. The area of action is this small portion on one side and the small portion on another side. So this portion is nothing but length L into thickness T. So it is 2 times of length into thickness. So it will be equal to 2 sigma 1 L into T. So we are applying these two formula for the limiting condition, where fluid pressure equal to circumferential stresses. So here, if we apply these two formulas, P D L equal to 2 sigma 1 L T, we will get the value of sigma 1 as P into D by 2T, where P is the internal fluid pressure, D is the internal diameter, 2 into T is the thickness. So this is the limiting value for sigma 1. Next, in the same way, when this cylinder is subjected to this internal pressure and failing due to longitudinal stresses, means how it will be? The bursting will take place when the internal pressure exerted on the cylinder is more than the resisting force at the cylinder longitudinal cross section. So here the fluid pressure is more than resistance due to longitudinal stresses. So if we take a cross section here, the internal resisting forces will act on the surface or throughout the thickness of the cylinder like this. So the sigma 2 will not be less than P value. If the sigma 2 value is less than this P value, then bursting or failure will happen. So in the limiting condition, again we are taking like fluid pressure will be equal to longitudinal stresses. So let us calculate the fluid pressure first of all. So the fluid pressure, whichever is acting here, is acting on the entire surface on this side and entire surface on that side. So the fluid pressure P is acting on the surface area of the cylinder. So here the force due to fluid pressure will be equal to P into area on which P is acting. So area on which P is acting is pi by 4 d square. This is the area where P is acting. The next resisting force, which is nothing but the resisting force happening at the cross section, is sigma 2 into area of which the force is acting. So here the area which force is acting is pi d into t throughout the perimeter into its thickness t. So it is equal to sigma 2 into pi d into t. So we will keep these two formula in the calculation of sigma 2 in the limiting condition where fluid pressure equal to longitudinal stresses. So here we will get p into pi by 4 d square will be equal to sigma 2 into pi d into t. From this we will get the value of sigma 2 as p d by 4 t. So if we observe here, sigma 1 value is p d by 2 t and sigma 2 value is p d by 4 t, which is nothing but half of sigma 1. So we can write like longitudinal stresses will be equal to half of circumferential stresses. So at any point in the material of the cylinder shell, there are two principal stresses. So after calculating this sigma 1 and sigma 2, what is given here? At any point in the cylindrical material, if we take at starting point or if we take at ending point in that cylindrical shell, there are two principal stresses, namely circumferential stresses and longitudinal stresses, which are in short sigma 1 and sigma 2. So if we consider this sigma 1 and sigma 2, which are acting perpendicular to each other, from this we will calculate the maximum shear stress that is produced in the cylinder. So these two principal stresses acting, one is parallel to the axis and one is perpendicular to the axis, then the maximum shear stress tau max will be equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by 2, where it is pd by 2t minus pd by 4t by 2, that will be equal to pd by 8t. So the maximum shear stress value is pd by 8t. So these are the values for sigma 1, sigma 2 and tau max in thin cylinders. So with this knowledge, we are going to solve some problems in the next video. Thank you. See you in the next video.